Hi everyone, welcome to TechKato. In this series, I'm gonna show you how to integrate Firebase to WordPress by using Integrate Firebase PRO plugin. This tutorial is done for the version 0.7.0. There may be changes in the future, however, the core features should be the same. Now, we start to download the plugin and install it to a WordPress site. In order to download the plugin, you go to firebase.downwind.me. You should read the user guide before the latest features. And just to make sure that this is the one that you need, if there are a feature that you need but not available yet, you still can support my work and request a feature later. The user guide can be found by going to the user guide tab and click to the Firebase WordPress docs. Okay, it's gonna lead you to another document site. This is where you find the latest features and update tutorials that you can use on your WordPress site. And we're gonna download by going to the download tab. And you have to log in with your Gmail account. After you sign in and you pay for the plugin, you're gonna see a link that you can like download it. I'm already saved, so I'm gonna go straight to the folder. After you download it, you can uncompress the folder and you will see there are two files inside the folder. Before doing anything, you should click on the README and read the guide if there is any breaking changes. Okay. The Integrate Firebase PRO.zip, this is a plugin file, and you can install it by uncompress this folder and then put it into your plugins folder in your WordPress site. Or you can do it in the conventional way, that you're gonna go to dashboard and then go to plugin and then add new. You're gonna upload the plugin and then choose file and then upload the Integrate Firebase PRO.zip and then you open it. And then you click on install now. After you install, you're gonna activate the plugin. In the version 0.7.0, the Firebase tab is no longer under the settings. You're gonna find it directly under the commands tab. This is the dashboard after you install the Firebase plugin. They're gonna have the general tab, the database tab. There's nothing in the database tab yet before you update the settings here. Okay, so you're gonna have your base domain in the Firebase and then the token for the dashboard and the token for the frontend. The reason why we have two different kind of token here is because security purpose. When you log in as an administrator, you're gonna use the dashboard API to work with your Firebase database or users. It's completely secure and you should never reveal your dashboard API token. Okay, the frontend token is for the frontend, so everyone gonna see it, and it's okay. It doesn't do any important task that can harm the database or users. In the auth tab, this is the new feature. Okay, so the plugin use the Firebase UI web in order to help you to log in, register new user from Firebase to WordPress. That means when you have a user in the Firebase and then you log in through this one, you have the ability to create a new user in the WordPress and log in with your Firebase credentials. And after you log in, you can allow user to navigate to a specific site. If you have the terms and service or privacy URL, you can add it too. I'm gonna go to this feature in another video. Remember that you cannot use the database or users yet until you go to the settings and then update the base domain and dashboard API token. Okay, but the first step, we need to update the API key. So where can we find it? Here is the link that you can go to your Firebase console. After you go into your console Firebase, you can go to project overview and then project settings. Okay. If you don't have any app yet, you're gonna have to add a web app. Okay, and then you're gonna see Firebase configuration here, and you just need to copy and paste from your Firebase to the WordPress. Now I'm gonna add it. So after you add everything, you click save. After you update the Firebase credentials, the plugin, like, it can work now on the front end side, even though you cannot work with the database or users inside the dashboard. So with this configuration, you can do basic authentication. So for example, if I allow to sign in with email, and then after I sign in, I'm gonna go to the home page maybe, and if I have the terminal service URL, I can add it. And then save it. And then you're gonna check the authentication, okay? With this basic configuration, you can allow user to log in with their Firebase username and password. They cannot log in into your WordPress yet. Okay, not yet. Now I just log in as an example. After login, it's gonna go back to the home page, because in the configuration, I add the redirect URL that after user login, it's gonna go to the home page. And when you go back to the sign in, the login form is no longer there. In this stage, you can allow user to get data from Firebase or Firestore. So before doing that, I'm gonna check what is the shortcode of the sign in. So everything gonna be done through the shortcode. So in order to show the login form, this is what you need. And we're gonna go back to a list of current shortcodes in order to figure out what else do we need. So if we need to have a logout button, okay, we can add it too. Okay, this is gonna show the logout button. I'm gonna add some more. So in the authentication, okay, reading, I'm gonna do some reading. Like after user login, you have to show them something. Okay, reading. And then let's see what can I add. So if there is any error, we can add this one to show. In the plugin, I have the mechanism that when there is any error and you want to show it, you can add this shortcode too. Okay, and you can customize it by adding your own class, so you can style it later. I'm gonna add some more. Okay, so this shortcode gonna show the content inside it. So if you're not logging, you're gonna see this content. Okay, what happened when you log in? Okay, so when you log in, you're gonna have this shortcode that you're gonna show only for login user. only login user. Let's see it. Okay, and then I'm gonna update. Okay, and then I'm gonna view page. Okay, so this is the sign out button. This is the reading shortcode. So you're gonna read it and then you're gonna show the display name. Okay, and only login user can see this light up word. Okay, so you can control what user see, and then when you sign out, the login form gonna show again, and this text appear because you are not logged in. So this is how you control the content for the login user and not login user. There is another advanced feature that you're gonna show the content based on the user claims in the Firebase. So for example, if the user have like admin custom claim, they're gonna see the content. But even if you log in and you don't have that custom claim, you're not gonna see it. So this is a cool feature when you want to create a content site that allows certain people to like, see the content. I'm gonna go to the detail in another tutorial. Okay. Let me try to log in again. Okay, yeah, you're gonna redirect to the homepage. And here, when you go back, you're gonna see it again. Pretty easy, right? We only need the API key, the Firebase credentials, and the Firebase UI web configuration. Okay, that's all. That's all what we need.